Hey guys, Crew Blind Wave, I'm Eric.
Rick.
I'm Calvin.
I am Aaron.
And we're back with Vinland Saga, last time on...
Challenge you to a duel!
Yes.
So and... it got smaller.
Yep.
He pulled out his knife.
Which I still feel sometimes like, dad. With that knife, I'm gonna like, skip up on the blade.
Just hold it tighter.
I guess so.
Grab it firmer.
Why do you think that?
I need to look at it.
It's
because
it doesn't have like a, any kind of like guard on it. I don't know.
It doesn't have a curved like, guard?
I mean, it goes up like this, but I feel like my finger's going to go up if I hit something too hard.
Let's buy one.
Let me look at it again, I guess.
They must be available somewhere, right?
Maybe. Like a shop, like a vendor.
Yeah. Let's try it.
Well, they killed and burnt the vendor.
Damn.
It's like...
It's interesting. I wasn't expecting them to, like... do things like that, and so far a lot of it's been very like England is bad, and the Vikings like sure like watching it was bad, right? Like Thorfinn sure. watching the raid and the fire
poor
and
as hell.
Stuff, and that was terrible and stuff. But they like had us meet people that are most likely dead now from the Viking raid, who were like just helping a little Viking boy.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
He caused little pirate
In the moment when he saw his own family, like while looking at her or not looking at her, I'm really sure. But that moment was pretty good.
I mean, she might not have still been standing there, but just the sight of her frozen, staring at him, was burned into his mind.
Was he ever able to communicate? Like, they didn't know what the runaway was? Is that what the idea is then? Because that was the one thing is I wasn't 100% sure if, like, when he stood there holding that fire and said, run away, and then he just took off, like... Did he know enough of listening to them to know what it was? Or is that just him just speaking in his own language then?
It's just him speaking.
That's why he comes like, I told you to run away. Why didn't you listen? It's like, obviously they couldn't hear you.
I think so.
Because it was hard to tell a little bit.
Yeah, because they're both speaking English.
They're both speaking English, which I like knowing what both of them are saying. But I wasn't 100% sure of like, you know, that's the thing. Is like, I don't know when, like if he was ever speaking anything they could understand.
Yeah.
I wouldn't know it.
Yeah.
Because I would just hear English.
I didn't expect them to give people from England an English accent. I just didn't. It makes sense, but it's not like the Danes have an accent or anything.
Sure.
They don't seem to, at least. But I was like kind of almost thrown off guard. I was like, oh, okay. Well, I mean, this is good, because at the very least now, they can communicate who is speaking what, as opposed to just having a different language being spoken.
Yeah. Well, and if we're riding with the Viking side of things, like, for the most part... If we were a Viking, we would know that we have a Viking accent, right?
Yeah.
Like, that's the idea. Like, whenever you're from wherever, you don't hear your own accent, really. That's just how voices sound.
Yeah.
So, like, us kind of hearing that, like, maybe that's supposed to be a distinguishing thing of, like, this is England. We're hearing, like, we're invading into another place that we aren't normally in.
Yeah.
And our characters aren't normally in, so they sound different.
Mm-hmm.
But they also speak English. All of them do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So they're talking about, in terms of the wider setting, that this is kind of the stuff that's happening before the big invasion, right?
Yeah.
Before the King of Denmark. But the Vikings are joining the Danes, and they will invade England, but they're kind of getting in there and like taking things out before it officially happens.
They're softening the defenses, and the...
That way the Danes can come in and do a big push.
Yeah.
And even, I don't remember who it was saying that... Could be in a few years before they come.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, they're like the Buccaneers, right? They're state-funded pirates. They're just there to disrupt the economy of England.
Yep.
And get themselves rich in the process.
But he really took that that promise to heart. Like, you need great feats on the battlefield. So, at first I was like, oh, man, he made his first kill. This is probably really going to fuck with him. And then it's like, and then he's killed 50 people since then. Or I don't know how many people he's killed total, but...
He's killing so many, he needs another deck.
He's a little killer, and like the average warrior can't deal with him now.
Yeah.
He like kind of jumped that. I wonder if that means that, or at least the average Englishman, because he's not attacking Vikings.
Sure.
Right, so I wonder...
How close is he to taking on
Where does he stand in terms of these men? Like, is he middle of the road? They seem to be giving him more and more responsibility.
Well, they sent him to do the scouting.
That's true. There's probably, like, hesitation, too. So, like, you know, I really don't want to kill this kid.
Yeah.
Yeah.
True.
Now I'm dead.
Like, I think that was...
Now he jumped on my face and stabbed me twice in my neck.
I think it's definitely true, especially in, like, his first killer, too. Where, like, it could be easy seeing a kid running at you and be like, wait, what? A kid? And then by the time you're connecting the dots of everything, you're dead.
Like, the first guy that Ascalon saved him from. He was like, come here, kid. Are you one of these pirates? You know, one of these Danish pirates? You know, what are you doing here?
Yeah. And he hesitated.
He wasn't going to kill him. Yeah. And
then the next one, we saw him fight on the one battlefield. Like, he looked like he was kind of like, and he just got. And then after that, it kind of got more and more. As like, he's gotten older. Calvin, you said it was like 6 years?
Yeah, that final, like, time jump thing where it went back to their village later, it was like 1008 instead of 1002. So it's been like 6 years that he's been with this band, I think.
His voice has deepened.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Changed actors.
So he's like probably between 16 and 18 years old now.
Well, he was 6 in episode 2.
Was he?
I thought he was 6.
So he's like 12.
12? I guess that makes sense. He's about Leon's age now, right?
Yeah.
Leon's voice is changing.
Yeah.
That surprised me when he came in the other day.
Yeah, he's like, look at this little man.
Yeah. Hey.
He's deeper than mine.
Yeah. Can't wait.
Yeah.
I don't know why the fleas all like jumping off at once like it was their own little mini invasion was
funny.
Yeah. He's like, why am I itching? And you look at him and they're all like, rah!
Quick, before they get in the food.
Yeah.
Yep. Do you think that the mom and the daughter will die or are dead?
I don't know.
Like, she was there and then she was just gone. And I'm like, like, was she taken by a Viking? You know, is that what happened there?
I don't think that, like, anybody that was there when they started to raid probably just didn't survive.
Yeah.
Like, that's why I said, like, I told you to run. Now it's too late.
Like, all of them, it seemed like, that were there came running down the hill from you know, the further reaches. Mm-hmm. Like, by the time she got there, she was late and she was tired. So trying to run back away.
I mean, you could say, like, just the visual, like, metaphor that she's literally swept away.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know? I was just thinking that maybe the daughter, because, like, they'll take women and stuff. Maybe the daughter would be there, and maybe Thorfinn would be like, no, this one's mine. Mm-hmm. And, like, stop anyone else from, like, getting her.
Like protect her or something.
Maybe. I just wondered if something like that could happen, if she could be alive or anything. Her hair, and I mean, she's also just blonde, but
her hair was very reminiscent.
It reminded me of something from, like, the intro. And I was like, I wonder if she could be alive and later on maybe be something or something, but maybe not.
I don't know.
But yeah.
No, I mean, it was sad with the woman, like, kind of seeing her son John, instead of her youngest son, right?
Yeah.
Her son John in him, and then seeing that is not the case. Because John is probably a good Christian boy, and I don't think that...
Is John, you think, her son's name?
Yeah, she said John.
Yeah.
Well, she called him John, right? She said you'll
never replace John.
Okay.
Her daughter said, like,
I didn't hear that part.
You know, we don't know who he is. He'll never replace John.
I heard her say, like, yeah, this is my son. His name's John. Mm. But I don't remember that part there. So that's why I was like, man, she just came with a name real quick.
No, she didn't make it up. She just made it him.
Her crying there at the end, too.
Yeah.
Sad.
Uh-huh.
It's like losing her son again kind of thing, like looking at him.
Yeah.
It's interesting, this where he's finally a killer and killing. This is titled The Journey Begins.
Mm-hmm.
As opposed to what I felt like was kind of a beginning earlier, but no, this is seems to be.
He's on a path.
He is on a path.
A war path.
Yeah.
Man, I don't know how.
He saved. He saved Ashgalad, right?
Yeah.
That one time, throwing the knife.
Yeah, that I took as like a thing of, like, no one else is gonna kill you. I'm getting better, and I'm gonna be the one to kill you.
Sure.
You know, like, I don't know how. Like, we talked about this being the Vinland Saga and what it could mean, but so far I don't get the connection yet.
You know? I get you.
Like, we're talking about, like, Vinland. Ah, where's Vinland? It's like, but they're going to England. Yeah. This is different. So I don't know what this is.
Well, like I said, maybe the idea of Vinland being almost like an afterlife or a perfect world where there is no war.
Sure.
You know? Because that's kind of what Thor talked about, that runaway slave about.
So that maybe, was like his dream to,
that could be
to take his people there.
Maybe if he realizes what Thor was talking about when it came to war. And
like Thorfinn grows up, like, and takes his people there.
Vinland might be a promise of, like, it is a place. I knew a guy. His name was Leif. You know?
Maybe.
I don't know.
One guy got shot right in the ass.
Ah! Something bit me! Yeah, it did. I don't think I have much else about the episode. I mean,
I know how he got a second dagger.
Yeah.
So took it off. He's all equipped now.
Yeah.
Sure.
Leveled up.
And is that the dagger that he's using in the intro?
Yeah, I imagine so.
Yeah, it's got more of like a cross hilt.
I was like, well, okay, this one seems to have a lot of sentimental value, but I know that he uses two daggers. I wonder where the second one comes from, and then it's just...
He just takes it.
It's looted. Yeah. Yeah, I get you.
I think about it earlier when after you said about like that one dagger, look at the goodness, I'm gonna kill myself.
Yeah.
But I'm like, I don't know, I use lots of knives and like don't go up on the blade. And also I feel like most hilts are made more so for like protecting from like when blades hit and they slide down, that you don't get attacked by the other person's sword, not to necessarily prevent you from going up the blade.
Well, I'm not an expert. I do feel like they're mainly made for that, so your hand doesn't go up. But you also don't, you aren't using your kitchen knives and stabbing really hard, you know?
You don't know what I do with my kitchen knives.
You're right. Guys, thank you very much for watching this episode of Vinland Saga with us. Please subscribe so that every time a new episode comes out, you can check out the reaction as soon as it comes out. It's really easy. You just go down and hit the subscribe button. Well, wait.